Set that white balance thing. All right, so here we go. Let me write this. This is going to have some long names to it, but it's no big deal. I have to draw that end to end. So color those in a little bit if you want. SchroederDiamond. That end's taken care of with the H. So if you could follow this is the most complex reaction that beginning university level third year biochemistry students study. I don't even know how much they study the real mechanism of this. This is going to go back to be two sulfurs next to each other. So just connect the arm. So that's one of the bonds. These bonds go down to a carbon. There's one carbon in between. Then it goes down to the rest. The enzyme there, which is a carbonyl to a nitrogen to five more to the cell membrane. This is lysine. So again, from the middle of this enzyme, out comes a lysine that is bound to the lipoic acid, which now again is happy. It's in the ring. Got all the electrons around here, remember I was saying? So with all those electrons pulling on it, it allows a carbon diamond that's being pulled on that BS1 there. What it's going to get going to hit the sulfur, that one. This is going to get a proton brought in. Again. Lipoic acid, riboflavin, vitamin BS1, acetyl coenzyme A, and lipoic acid. There's so much going on in this. Okay, I gotta show you this here because I wanna show you that the Schroeder-Niemann technique works. What we're looking at here is such a complex reaction. I mean, it's, we can't even fit it on one piece of paper here. The vitamin B1 is carrying the acyl group. The lipoic acid here is going to take it. So what's going on right here? Can't get the resolution on it, but these two sulfurs were bound together. This sulfur, nitrogen carbon sulfur in this ring was holding the acyl group. So what it's able to do is have an enzyme come by, make it such that this carbon is going to have an electron pair. The electron pair is going to do what's called a nucleophilic attack on the sulfur. And it'll just leave. This carbon will be happy because of the double bond with the nitrogen. So it'll kind of just kind of take off. The lipoic acid section breaks the ring open. It protonated that sulfur. And then this sulfur got a little delta plus on it because the electron left over here. Electron took the proton, made a bond to real hydrogen here. Covalently bound hydrogen. So the electron that left, a little plus charge on the sulfur, made it that this acyl carbon here, that's just the methyl, there's two carbons here, methyl, now with the OH, blam, into the sulfur, and then it just comes off. So then you're left with the acyl group here, able to then be given to the acetyl-coenzyme A, which then, to get it re-ready again, because now you got two H's on these sulfurs, you got the FAD, it's a benzene ring, two nitrogens in a ring, another ring here, the two H's are going to go into that, the double bond's going to go from the sides, this is riboflavin. So just to show you again, what have we had in this? We've got riboflavin, vitamin